Hi there, Spark fans. Rob Reynolds here with some exciting news. I mean, I tend to well up with childlike excitement with pretty much everything we put out, but some products are just, well, extra. Let me share with you one such product. Now, this introduces some cutting-edge technology and does the work of several other boards. Introducing the new SparkFun OpenLog Artemis. Now, this is a perfect board if you just want to grab a ton of data and log it to a CSV file, but it does so much more than that. Come on, let's take a look. This board is driven by SparkFun's own Artemis module, a Cortex-M4F-based Apollo 3 microcontroller. It is configurable via its CH340E USB to serial chip and our new simple Artemis firmware upload GUI. It has an operating voltage range from 3.3 to 6.5 volts via the VIN with an optional external power switch. It'll take 5 volts with USB via the 5-volt pin or a USB Type-C connection, or 3.6 to 4.2 volts from a LiPo battery via VBAT or the 2-pin JST connector. With that, there's also a built-in MCP73831 single-cell LiPo charger with a minimum charge rate of 450 milliamps. So don't use any LiPo smaller than that or it'll blow up like a pufferfish. The current consumption is about 20 milliamps in run mode and about 240 microamps in sleep mode. As far as ports go, the OLA has a USB Type-C connector for power, programming, and LiPo charging, a 2-pin JST LiPo connector, a Qwiic connector for I2C with power control, one SWD 2x5 header, 4 analog-to-digital pins, a serial port with logging speeds up to 921 600 bits per second, and a microSD socket which supports FAT32 and the older FAT16 formats with power control. There's also an onboard real-time clock with a 1 milliamp hour battery backup, plus an ICM2948 9-axis IMU communicating via a SPI interface. And finally, there are LEDs on board for power, LiPo charge indication, serial TX and RX, and status. Aside from having the speed and power of the Artemis chip, this board replaces the capabilities of two of my go-to workhorses, the OpenLog and the NineDoF Razer, with an upgrade to the latter. Whereas the NineDoF used the MPU9250 IMU, this board uses the newer ICM2948, capable of nearly 250 Hz on all 9 axes. Now, if you followed along with this board in its SparkX incarnation, I want to point out some upgrades that we've made since then. We've added a dedicated 3.3 volt regulator for Qwiic bus power cycling. Additionally, we've added a resistor divider to let you monitor your battery voltage. We've broken out an external reset pin so that if your project is in an enclosure, you can add an external button to reset the board. Similarly, we've broken out an external shutdown pin to allow you to tell the board to stop logging. Now, on this one, we've gone to an ENIG finish to avoid oxidation and help with solderability. And additionally, the power LED is now software configurable for even lower power draw in sleep mode. We've also been pushing hard on the firmware side of this. We have a simple GUI for Windows, Linux, Raspberry Pi, and Mac that will allow you to quickly and easily upgrade firmware. Aside from the standard firmware on your OLA, we currently also have firmware designed to let you log seismic activity detected by your SM24 geophone so you can monitor earthquake activity. Or perhaps you want to log high-rate raw UBX messages from your uBlox GNSS module. If you're looking to log and then post-process that data with RTKlib, you've got a firmware package for that as well. But today, I just want to talk about the standard firmware. If you're looking to log a ton of data quickly and simply, this is your out-of-the-box solution. Seriously, connect it to your computer, open up a terminal window. It's going to auto-detect close to 24 of our Qwiic I2C boards and just start spitting out data. Even without an SD card installed, it's still going to feed data directly to your terminal window, TeraTerm, RealTerm, whatever you're comfortable with. And if you're not comfortable with terminal programs, you can even use your Arduino IDE's serial monitor to read the data. I mean, if you can read it that quickly. And since we're talking about the standard firmware, let's talk about how many things it will read at once. And with our recently revised MUX breakouts, this will read up to 64 buses at once. And not 64 devices, 64 buses. So sure, you could read 64 identical devices, or you could read data from 21 buses, each with 7 devices. Now, why would you need to read data from 154 devices every 10th of a second? Hey, we don't ask, we don't judge. We just make it possible and let you do you. So let's take a look at our hectodecapus. I'm connecting our SparkFun OLA to a pair of Qwiic MUX breakouts that are daisy chained. From there, I've got 16 of our Qwiic scales plus one uBlox GNSS module. Now, all I have to do is connect this to the computer, open up a terminal window, Make sure it's set at 115.2, and the OLA will start doing its thing. Now, that is a ton of data whizzing by, so let's slow it down and take a look and see what it's telling us. Hitting any key is going to bring up the main menu, and you've got options there to configure a whole bunch of stuff, detect your devices, things like that. Now, if you don't do anything with it for 15 seconds, it's going to tell you that no input was detected and just start logging again, like that. So let's stop it again and figure out what these numbers are. You can do that by hitting H, as in help. It will tell you what they are, but it will immediately start logging again. So you can stop it once more, and then you can see here we've got our real-time clock, date and time, followed by our IMU data. After that, we've got our weight from our 16 quick scales. There's no scales hooked up, so it says no unit. Finally, we've got our GPS info, and at the very end, our output speed in hertz. And then once again, you're rolling. Now, I want to demonstrate a little multi-sensor data logging too. I had hoped to go up into the mountains to a cave and measure ceiling height, humidity, temperature, possibly even ambient light as I descended deeper into the cave. But with the current wildfires in Colorado, that is not possible right now. So I'm just going to have to do it around here at SparkFun headquarters and use my imagination. I'll log data every 3 seconds, then we'll throw it into a CSV file and take a look and see what we've got. Now, one of the nice features of this board is that when you plug in the battery, it doesn't automatically start logging. You have to hit the reset button, so you're not logging information before you need it. Additionally, if it senses that you haven't logged something for 2 seconds, it automatically goes into sleep mode. Now, with this low power mode, with a 200 milliamp hour battery, this thing will draw such a low amount of current that you can run it for, well, by our estimation, close to 10 years. So let's start it up and pretend we're going into a cave. All right, there we go. We're measuring temperature. We're measuring distance to the roof. Pretty high out here. Let's head inside. All right, now we'll just grab this data, throw it into a spreadsheet, and see what we have. Now, since this logs all its information in CSV format, all you have to do is import it into a spreadsheet, and voila. Now, usually at this point, I would wrap up by saying something like, "So that's it." But with this board, that is so not it. There's so much more that this thing is capable of. You can definitely expect to see Avra and I spending a lot of time with this board, coming up with some cool new projects. But hey, don't wait for us. Head over to sparkfun.com now and pick up your OpenLog Artemis. And as always, stay safe, be kind, and happy hacking. We also have, no, not that, not yet. Don't get ahead of yourself, Rob. Now, this introduces some cutting edge technology and also replaces the work? That's not what you say. From the top. We call it the OLA, but I want to call it the OLA. Say hi to OLA. That's all I'm saying.
Okay.